Callie Chaffee, and today I'll be playing for you Scherzo in D minor by Cornelius Gerlich.
It's interesting because it's called the scherzo. You know, scherzo literally means joke in Italian, you know, but it's come to take on so much more than that. If you look at the Chopin scherzos, I mean, those are not jokes, those are big dances. So this is has more drama in it than the typical scherzo. There are a few little playful moments in it, but very nice. You feel comfortable playing a little faster?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That'll be my first thing, you know, Raji. Yeah, it was kind of getting to the point, you know, like in the middle section where I was getting three, bar by bar a little bit, so I want to get a little longer phrasing units. Yeah. That'd be too fast.
I can try.
Yeah, okay. Nice and loose, as I've been saying to many students, keep the wrists and arms loose. I would love to hear more right hand from you. Try to back off the bass a little bit. That's okay, okay. Yeah, why don't you play your right hand for me by itself, okay? Let's go through the right hand. Round out, so when it's playing up here, the pinky is going to be more rightward and then more towards the thumb. This is a great exercise for making these sort of oval shapes, rotation, and rounding out. Let's try it at that speed. See, I don't feel like you angle it enough when you play the pinky. right? So you go as slow as you need to. That's better. Yeah, keep a nice curve. Yeah, you're kind of going flat also on your pinky, so that's impeding things a little bit, so keep a nice curve. So don't go, if anything, you should be in a little higher position when you play your pinky, and you're going low.
Okay.
Yeah, when you did that, your sound was more even, when you had the curve and the... Dramatic moments.
Okay.
Arrivals here, you know, when you get to these fortissimo chords and such. I noticed you weren't really using pedal in some of these places. I think you use it in the middle only, but I was missing some of those rhythmic pedals that could really boost the sound. Can I have the piano for a second, please? Yeah, so when you get to... Sound there, right? You're just gonna be forward, a little bit forward into the keys, no need to stiffen them. This part's quite easy. So just forward, forward, right on those chords. Yeah, and I would actually delay that chord a little bit,
okay,
since it is a surprise. Let's go extra slow, but can you sing out a little bit more on the top and light your left hand? Okay, let's back up and just do the right hand by itself. And actually, I want you to play without pedal, please. I want to see what you're doing with your fingers. Yeah, okay, yeah. Well, why it's important, because then you can tell, you know, what your fingers are actually doing and if your fingers are having some gaps in there. There could be a lot more manual legato going on. Supplements, but it can't hide everything.
Okay.
It can conceal to an extent, right? But if you're chopping up too much in there, it will sound a little, you know, get some hiccups in there. So try to hold all your time, all those long notes, okay?
Sure.
Yes, please, really slow. So actually, let me take it a step further. I think I know the answer to this, but do you ever practice the voices independently?
No.
Yeah, I appreciate your honesty. Thank you. Yeah, that's something I have my students do, because then you can really gain full control, you know, if you work on a fugue, for instance, of every single voice in the exact articulation that you want to do. So I'm going to have you try that now. We're going to use just the soprano. So you can really listen that you're holding and connecting everything. Now this one right here. That'll be kind of hard to connect. Or you could actually go four and then switch afterward.
I think I was doing three.
Okay. Let's try soprano by itself. See how legato you can make that. No, just the soprano. Yeah. On the white keys is around the middle.
Okay.
When possible. Now, of course, sometimes you have to go in, but
yeah.
Do that again, please. And now focus on engaging more of your arm behind the fingers so we get that tone that I was missing that we'll sing. Changing your fingers,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So what I have my students do is I'll have them write every single finger number down when they practice sections like that.
Okay.
So they are, because they'll be tempted to change it, you know, to something that's a little different. Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Highly recommend that. And you can go through all the voices that way. Okay. I won't have you do that now, but I would try that. Okay. Let's go ahead though for now, put it back together, but we'll go, I want to take it to adagio. For now, it's just to work on the tone, okay? And see if you can keep that singing tone and the arm that you were doing first. Okay, now we're gonna add the pedal.
Okay.
Yeah. Right hand. This part's a little easier because you can get these separations. You're letting go of your seat. Once you get it faster, you're going to get more line going, for sure. Okay. Let's just do this last section here, okay? A nice light left hand. Wonderful to work with you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.